Welcome again to another episode, ladies and gentlemen. So, let's wrap this up quickly. Before I begin, here are some leaks to the new attires we're gonna get this season. So, who's excited for a winged horse? First thing is first, let's talk about the new changes in the game. We have a kinda major change, which is the hay of the horse is gone, because the HP or the hit points of the horse is also gone. Yes, you did hear that right. So you need to repair the kits and you can massacre all the horses you can. Second, we have a new map, which is 12 versus 12, which sounds interesting on the paper. Thirdly, we have the awesome 3 new units of this season. And yeah, you did hear that right. All of them are seasonal, including the Houndsman, which, I mean, some people, just like me, expected that they would be the tier 5 of the longbows, but no. Sorry to disappoint you, they are a seasonal unit. So, without any further ado, let's explain them one by one. So, starting with the Houndsmen, they have two formations. The first, where the dog will just stand beside you, or beside the soldier, and the second, the dogs will form an arc in front of the unit. Does it matter? Yes, just wait till you hear the traits. So, their skills are kinda straightforward and simple. You have a kinda unique skill, which is the first one. They take a stance and they will shoot 3 consecutive arrows. The second skill will be targetable and they just like throw arrows that slow the enemy. The third skill, which is the most intriguing of them, is the mini Hishikji charge for the hounds or the dogs, because they are super cute. So, you literally just like charge in, after a couple of seconds, you can order your dogs to charge back, or the dogs will automatically charge back as soon as they reach the end of the charge. So, how do you play with this? You can charge in and press V and the dogs will start attacking, but you will break the skill, or just like let it be, like charge in, charge out, and that's it. Now, let's move to the unit traits. So the first important thing that you need to keep in mind is the passive between the dog and the hunter. So, if the dog dies, the hunter gains 120% more damage. If the hunter dies, the dog will be enraged for 5 seconds, then it will die. Hence, if you wanna counter the units, you need to go for the hunters. The second passive: if both the hunter and the hound attack the same target, they gain an offensive buff. The third trait: if the dog attacks a unit, it suffers a reduction in its attack power as well as its speed. Last but not least, for this unit, the hunter may cause bleeding with the arrow. Second on the list, we have the Claymores, a 4-star unit that is kinda tanky and deals nice amount of damage, and they are quick, like they're really quick when you press double C. So their skills are simple and straightforward, but here's the catch. So the first skill is the charge, the second skill is like an offensive power buff, like kind of a Dread Mode or something, and you have for freedom, which is the catch. So, when you read the combo slowly, like pose and read it, your combo should go like this. You charge in with the skill number 1, then if the unit is kind of faltering, use the skill number 3, and during the first 15 seconds of the skill number 3, you need to use the second skill to activate the passive, which will heal them and grant them extra defense. This is the passive of the skill number 3 for freedom. Take your time to read it. Just keep in mind that the third skill, yes, it gives a huge buff for 15 seconds, but after that, the unit is weakened for 10 seconds, which I'm not gonna judge right now in the BDR, I'm still waiting for the actual version of the game. In terms of their traits, every time a soldier attacks, he stacks up defense, like 40 points of defense, which is a maximum of 5 times, so a maximum of 200 points in his defense, you know? So in other words, this might be the diamond of this season. You just need to learn how to combo and use their skills together. Last but not least, we have the Bagpipers. They are just a simple humble 2 buff aura unit, and if you wanna do like you saw in the video where you just like buff a cavalry unit and let it charge directly into bikes, you need to understand the skill number 3. So the skill number 3 has a cooldown, unlike the first two. So you're using the, let's imagine this, you're using the attack buff or the defense buff. If you press the skill number 3, you will extend its range, and any unit standing inside the aura will gain the buff for 10 whole seconds, even if they exit it. So, in the normal circumstances, if you buff a unit, as soon as this unit leaves the aura field, it loses the buff. So in other words, you need to coordinate with your teammates, like, hey, I'm gonna give you the buff and you're just gonna rush in. Something like that, okay? And that was it. Of course, the Vitrancy tree will be explained later on, if needed, when the season starts, on 20th of this month. So stay tuned and see you in the battlefield, Warlords.